It is at the pub, so that's bad enough, but I didn't have chips.
Yeah, oh, that's alright.
It's a proud moment in history.
Yeah?
What are you having for tea?
Probably Guinness.
Yeah.
It's a four-course
meal in a
glass. It is. It's strange. The only way I can kind of describe mastering is it brings the songs to life and makes them. It makes them wider. It makes them bigger. It makes them. Well, I suppose as a master, you can make it do whatever you want. But for me personally, what I find when you sprinkle the magic dust on top of the songs, they come back alive.
For me, it's like mastering's the last 10% that it's impossible to get. I could sit there and try and make an audio file that's done sound better, but I just wouldn't get anywhere. It would just get steadily and steadily worse. But yeah, it really smooths it all out, and especially when you're doing an album. For me, like, the gap between the songs was super important. I didn't want anything lingering around too long, and I wanted it to be a comfortable journey where, you know, there's room to breathe, but also no one's like, where's the next track? So I feel like we got it really good in the end.
Yeah.
I had a little tear in my eye when we finished. I was pretty emotional because it'd been a long journey getting the album done. But yeah, I'm super, super proud of it and very happy.
For me, with mastering, it's a different way of listening.
Yeah.
They're listening for, you know, tempo, pitch. Yeah. You know, making sure the vocals right, that sort of thing, and not necessarily then going away, having a break, coming back and sitting down and listening as you would to anybody else's work. And I find quite a lot of the work is actually creating that cinematic sound and getting the thing to spread across from the center to the sides as well, so it sounds bigger. You know?
Do you find that a lot of people are trying to make stuff super, super loud for the sake of making it loud? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I especially find on some streaming services, like, stuff just sounds... It's like a war to see who can get the loudest.
Mm.
But then the whole song just lacks a dynamic.
Yeah.
And it is just all, like, one thing, which I find a bit crazy, I mean, really.
There has always been a loudness war.
Yeah.
But I think now... With the streaming services, there's a thing called LUFS, which is a measurement of volume over time and instantaneous volume. And I don't think people yet understand that squashing something as much as you possibly can actually make it sound quieter on a streaming service. Yeah. And something with more dynamics will sound louder. The problem was that the track was turned down so that the loudest part was correct.
Right.
But it was just making the start of the track seem a bit too dull.
Right.
Too quiet.
Yeah.
And so what I needed to do was have the start as it was.
Yeah.
And somehow managed to still get that big lift when the track kicked in. So there's the start comes in at the level, and then this yellow section is just a really long crossfade.
Lay it all on the table, cause soon or later it's back again. I know that I messed up.
I never noticed that, you know. Now you've pointed it out, I do, but...
Yeah, I was dreading telling you, to be honest, but...
No, I think it's the right thing to do, though. Will make me a better man.
You'll make me a better man. So how can you sleep at night? Tell me you think I deserve this. Tell me now what should I do? Cause I'm standing paralyzed.
You can hear everything on these speakers.
It helps.
They're amazing.
Wow. That sounds sick.
The guitar sounds like it's... Whoa! Yeah. That's blown my mind, that has. The harshness of that top end, which you can kind of hear a little bit, is totally smoothed out now.
That's what I was saying about a more cinematic sound.
Yeah, totally.
You know, just that... Adding a bit of width in there.
That's blown my mind.
And then... So this is a Waves multi-band limiter.
Right.
So you can shape how the limiter is working. And so the harder it's working doing the limiting, the more emphasis you'll get on certain areas.
Right.
So, for example, as it gets louder, it's not pushing that mid-range and it's not pushing the top.
Right.
Because it's already quite, you know, as on the edge as you want it to be.
Yeah.
But it just brings up the here, the lower end of your vocal, down to just above the kick. And then the kick's just pulled slightly back as well, so you don't get the car rattling sub.
Yeah.
But most of the, most of the work is
this is the bit of mastering here that I would never get my head around, because there's just too many buttons. I mean, look how many buttons are on that thing.
Yeah, I know. I use two or three.
Really?
Two or three buttons, yeah. Just...
Leave the rest to zero. Easy.
No idea what they do. And then
I'd like to point out that we did all of this over email as well, which is really difficult. I find it's really, really difficult.
Like, yeah,
trying to put the right words, you know, to get what you want out of the music. I find is one of the hardest things.
I like checking it on your bang average headphones to see
what
the general public are going to hear. So just your Apple headphones.
Yeah.
Just checking how that sounds and how the average listener is going to hear it as well.
Hmm.
If it sounds good on them, then you know it must sound amazing in here.
It's mad how many people use them headphones.
I know.
Mad.
Yeah.
Wow. That's nuts.
And then
that's a huge difference.
And then we went to stems, so that's predominantly instrumental with some backing vocals, and then your lead vox is here.
Okay,
right.
Because I wanted to treat your vocal differently. I know it's getting late in the evening, knowing that you're broken and bleeding, receding back to the palace of
dreams. So it's not so wise
in comparison to the original vocal.
Yeah.
I've pushed the lower end of your range,
So
your vocal sounds a bit warmer.
Yeah. Quiet in the dark while the vixens cry. Quiet in the dark while the vixens cry. Quiet in the dark while the vixens cry. You ain't supposed to worry about what I know. You can pick out every single element. It's crazy.
This was good because the drummer, he just decided to come in there. We didn't plan that.
So he
did it with a sort of a
crude,
with a sort of decent guide drum, and then he took it, and we were gonna fade it, and then suddenly it was just it sounds drunk at the end.
Yeah.
We listen to it, and he's like, "Jeez, look, the drummer's just come out of nowhere," and it was really a lovely end, you know.
That's it.
It goes back to that that piece we did in Headline. It's like it makes it sound raw and real, and that's what music should be.
Exactly.
Yeah.